Good morning, everyone. Am I audible?
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, I'm audible now. Okay, let me share my screen then. So today we are going to discuss about the PILE Foundation. Okay. So we know what is foundation. We know the bottom part of your structure that carries the load of the structure is your foundation. So we'll be discussing about PILE Foundation. What are PILE Foundation? How many types of PILE Foundations are there? Okay. So see, these are your foundations which has to carry the load of the overall structure of your overall load of the structure. Okay, there can be the foundation can be shallow foundation or deep foundation. Okay, is am I audible? There's too much of noise, I think. Hello. Okay. So you see there are two types of foundation that can be your shallow foundation and deep foundation. Okay. So when your this depth of the foundation is less than your width of the foundation, then this is known as your shallow foundation. Your people know that, right? And what is a deep foundation? When your depth of the foundation with respect to your width of the foundation is greater than 1, it is called what? It is called your deep foundation. Okay. So this was your shallow foundation and your deep foundation. So your deep foundation can be your these foundations. So why PILE foundations are used? You know, when we have a PILE foundation, why we use PILE foundations? You see here, I'll show you. So these types of supports are your PILE foundation. So why we use PILE foundations? Because see, when you have a structure of a lesser load that has lesser load, we can use a small foundation here. So that here you see. Here you see this is your soft soil, this is your medium soil, and this is your hard soil. At the bottom most layer is your hard starter. So when you have a soft soil here and you have a small structure to be made here, this is a small house, the load of which is less. So this can rest on your small foundation, shorts. That is your shallow foundation. Okay, this soft soil can take this load. Okay, but what happens when your this is weak, the load will come and this will carry. Okay, but what about when we have a higher load structures like these heavier load structures? This is the weak soil. This cannot take the load of, and as a result what will happen? This may collapse. So what happens? We have to use PILE foundation. These are your PILE foundations which will move till the hard strata. Okay, so that they can give the support to your heavier structure above the ground level. Before, in the shallow foundation, what was happening? In the shallow foundation, we had, since the load was less, we could carry that load in the weak soil could carry that load. Okay, that's why we could use the shallow foundation. But in this case, when we have a heavier structure, heavier loaded bridges, etc., What we need to do, we make deep foundations. Why deep foundations? Because this heavier loads cannot be, when we use only shallow foundation in this weak soil, it is unable to carry or resist this much of heavier loads. Okay, so we use this pile foundation. Still, the pile foundations are the cylindrical, or you can say it can be square also. So it is when we have our depth of the foundation is with respect to your width is greater than 1, and it is lie resting on the hard strata. Okay, sometimes also what happens, these are your pile foundations, so these piles are going to transmit the load to the hard strata. Okay, so that's why we use the pile foundation in case of underground waters also. If there are some waters, what will happen? The shallow foundation, if we use shallow foundations, in that case it will collapse. And suppose due to rainwater, there is underground water will rise, and as a result, when we have shallow foundation, it will collapse. So we use what? Pile foundations. In that cases where we have underground water is high, okay. And this also helps in what? The lateral wind loads, or the load due to this earthquake, etc., or the friction load from this one resisting the soil. Okay, the water table. Then we have, due to when we have the underground waters are also more near some oceans or seas, etc., rivers. Okay, based on the metal, pile foundations are classified as what, you know. These can be timber, steel, then concrete. We have again composite. Composites will be made up of your timber as well as your concrete. Here the top portion can be the timber, and the concrete can be the column of the pile, okay, which acts as a column. So now, types of pile foundation based on the construction method. Based on your construction method, we have driven pile. See, this pile is driven with the help of this hammer. This can be concrete, timber, or steel piles. These are driven with the help of this drop hammer, and then they are driven till either it is. See here, what they have done here, they have hit here. This can be based on the construction method, right? Based on the construction method. So you have, this can be done by hammering from with the help of this heavy load. When you hammer, this is going to get driven inside the soil strata till the hard strata. It touches the hard strata. Or what it can be done, this is the hammering one. Then wait. This is your hammering till the hard, it reaches the hard strata. Or it can be pushed like this with the help of this. Another second method is bored one. Second method is bored pile foundation. Boring will be done here with the help of this equipment. Okay, so now boring is done. What we'll do, we'll put the reinforcement here, and then we can use the pile here, and then concreting is done, and then your pile is ready. Now, your type of pile foundation based on the structural behavior. That was the type of pile foundation based on your what? Based on your construction method. And this is your types of, there are different types of pile foundation based on your structural behavior, how they are behaving, your piles. Okay, so the first one being is your end bearing piles. What is your end bearing piles? See, when we have these loads, this is your pile. So when we have a huge load here, this is going to transfer the load from here top to this bottom hard strata. You are looking here, the stones are there, so hard stratas are here. So as a result of this, what will happen when this load is coming and falling here on the hard stratum? As a result of this, this load is also going to act here on the, your load is going to be taken by your hard strata. So as a result of this, the pile, it is when you have a building over here, suppose you have a structure, how much load this pile can transmit depends upon your this hard strata, how much this can bear. That is why it is known as your end bearing piles. Okay, based on the behavior, that means based on this end bear and this thing, the layer and layer hard strata, it is known, because this will be carrying the loads, transferring the loads here, and as a result, what will happen? This is your That's why it is known as your enduring piles, okay? Because this is going to, this can be concrete, okay? And your diameter is this much. This is how much? Your cross-section area into bearing capacity, also with the factor of safety, will give you your this thing, the pile height, okay? Then we have your, it can be number of piles, you can use different number of piles. You can use, there can be another type of the structure to the structure behavior, is your friction pile. Now, what is a friction pile? When we have a suppose here, when we have inserted or when we have driven these piles here on the soil layers, what is happening? We are this, there is friction between the soil here and the piles here. So there is friction between these two, and as a result of this friction, this is holding the building here. This is holding the structure above it, above the pile, because of what? Because of the friction between the soil and the pile. Okay. So you see the load is transferred here, and this is the friction. Due to the friction, also this is holding the load over the pile. Okay. Now one example you see here. This is one example where you have, this is the sands here, soil is given. Now when we pour this soil here, we'll pour the soil here on this cylindrical, this one plus. After that, what happens? You see, when we insert this scale here, due to friction, what is happening? This is holding it, right? Your this soil inside the cylindrical flask, what is happening? It is holding the scale there. That is, the scale is behaving as a structure, and it is holding this structure or the scale, you can say. So as a result of this, this is an example of your friction pile. Okay, as in the same way, your friction pile also holds this structure there due to this friction between the soil and the this one. Okay, so the surface area into your friction force divided by a factor of safety will give you your this thing, the pile bearing capacity. Okay, so what happens? This is your height, your diameter, or cylindrical piles are used here. This can be soil compactor piles. Many piles can be together driven here or placed here so that they can give the more strength. Okay, or and there another one is a sheet pile. In the sheet pile, sheet piles, when they are used, when we have suppose this water you're looking here, suppose underground water is there, you have to resist this waters. So in that case, we need to have sheet piles. Okay, we use sheet piles. You may have seen in the bridges over the rivers, etc., we are using pile foundations. Okay, so or well foundations. So what happens here? There are water, so we can use the sheet piles there. Okay, so because of the lateral, sheet piles will resist your lateral pressure from the water. See here, these are your sheet piles. These are your sheet piles, which is resisting the water from entering your caisson or your, this is the large well foundation. You can see the pile foundation here. Okay. So these are your sheet piles. Sheet piles are used. These are your piles, 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 piles. Sheet piles, which are used to so that this your so that it resists your water from entering into the pile. Okay, from entering into this caisson, you can see. Okay, these are your piles you're looking. The steel piles are used. Okay, sheet steel sheet piles. Okay, so that the water is resisted. Again, this is a well foundation. So we have, okay. So this was your tile foundations. Now we'll go to your about the well foundation. We have seen the pile foundations. Now what are your well foundations? Okay, we are going to when we do the well foundation, we need to know about caissons also. Caissons, okay. About the caisson, we'll talk first, or about the well foundation. Let me see. Okay, later we'll talk about the caissons. We'll talk about the well foundation first. So let me share my screen again. ओके So we'll talk about the well foundations. Now, what are well foundations? Well foundation is one of the most commonly adopted foundation for major bridges in India. Like this now, before this also I showed you, these were your well foundations with the help of piles on the sheet piles used, the well foundation was done. Okay. So this in bridges, over bridges, mostly it is well foundation is done. Okay. Since then, many major bridges across wide rivers have been founded on wells. Well foundation is preferable to pile foundation when foundation has to resist large lateral forces. Okay. So simply one or two piles you cannot use in the large when you have your constructing in a bridge. You're constructing the bridge around a river or across a river or like large where there is large watery areas. Okay, so in that cases we can use a well foundation. Okay, so the construction principle of well foundations are similar to the conventional well sunk for underground water, but relatively rigid in engineering behavior. Okay, like normally we construct the wells in our houses, so the construction is similar type but in a larger scale in the construction as a foundation. Okay, so one of the example, one of the example is your Taj Mahal. Here the well foundation is done. Why? See these, because it is across, it is on the sides of the river Yamuna, right? So Yamuna is this side somewhere. So and waters are also there inside in the beneath the structure. There is water also. So because it is near to the Yamuna here on the sides. So what happens here underground, this entire structure of the Taj Mahal, we have well foundations. Okay, mini wells are constructed beneath these and they act as your foundation. Okay, so one of the example of your well foundations is the Taj Mahal. Okay, beneath this with the foundation where we have the foundation of the entire area is well foundation. Well, so many wells are made and then their stones are inserted inside those wells and then they are supporting these structure. Okay, so now today we are going to discuss in this pretty the construction of well foundation, different types and shape of the well foundation, to know which type of well foundation is suitable for different types of soil strata, which type of well foundation can be used for different types of soil strata. Okay, so depending upon the shapes of the well foundation, obviously these are simple, like it can be circular, it can be double D well, it can be twin circular well, it can be double octagonal well, it can be rectangular well. Okay, based on the shapes, your well foundations are these types. So these are your shapes of the well foundation. This is the circular well foundation, the normal one. Then we have the double D. This looks like a D, right? So two D's are here, so it is known as your double D well foundation. We have double octagonal. This is your octagonal shape. This one, this one, this one. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So octagonal shape to double octagonal well. We have the rectangular well foundation. It can be double rectangular well foundation. It can be a dumbbell kind of. This looks like a dumbbell, right? So it is dumbbell kind of. Dumbbell shaped well foundation. Then we have multiple dredge hole wells. Okay, multiple dredge hole wells are also there. So these are your based on the shape, these are your different well foundations. Okay. The next is your types of well foundation. There can be different types like open caisson or well, box caisson, pneumatic caisson. Okay. That's why I thought of talking about the caissons before. Because you know, caissons are what? When you are constructing a well foundation here, before obviously before constructing the well foundation, what you have to do, if suppose you are making a circular well foundation, okay, it is circular in shape, the circular well foundation you are making. So to make this, obviously you will have to have some box kind of safety things, safety walls around it, so that are those are known as your caissons. Okay, that means caisson means case, like briefcase, suitcase. Why we say? Because they are cases where we can store or where we can that surrounds something, right? So these are your caissons. Suppose this is your caisson. First of all, caisson is made, and then inside this is the ground below strata. Now this caisson is made. This is safe. Now the construct this thing, the members can come here and then they can start constructing the found that is the well foundation here. The foundation works can be done here when okay sorry when we have the caisson. The caisson is nothing but the borders, you know, the borders on the sides or the outer walls of the well foundation. Before constructing a well foundation, you will have to have some borders around it so that there is no water entering inside. Just now, I think in the previous video, I showed you that the well foundation was made there with the help of sheet piles. Water was surrounding all the sides, so that is nothing but your caisson. Okay, caisson was prepared, and then inside that the pile foundation was done. Then the well foundation. So, with the help of piles, okay, the well foundation was done. So now we have these are your. Based on that, again, your well foundation is open caisson or well, open well, box caisson, and pneumatic caissons. Okay. So, types of well foundations are how much? Open caisson, it can be open. Open, that means your top and bottom both are open of the construction, this thing, the caisson. Based on your caisson, suppose this is a caisson here, this is the ground. So this was your caisson, right? This was your caisson from here to here. So it is open from up top and it is open from bottom also. And then this was your underground strata. Okay. So you can see here this is open. Your this was the caisson, circular caisson suppose. And here at the bottom it doesn't have any layer. Okay. At the top also it is nothing is there. Only it is this kind of circle hole is there, suppose this is large hole, I mean to say. Okay, so this is open from top and open from bottom, and it is large in diameter. Okay, so this is your caisson. So when it is open from top and the bottom and the well is constructed here, it is known as your open caisson, or it looks like your well, only that caisson is used around the well foundation. So when it is open from both the sides, top and bottom, it is known as your open caisson or open well foundation. Open well foundation. Okay. Now box caisson is what? It is open at the top here, but it is closed here. You see here. Suppose now this was your caisson open. Now we have this is closed from the top, and now we can use this caisson here. Okay. Suppose this is the caisson, that is a box kind. Nah? It looks like a box that is from the bottom. It has the closing, and there is op this is open. The top layer is open. So now when we move the caisson bo at the bottom of the strata, this was your strata. When we make this touch the strata, what happens? This will form a boundary layer, and then inside the well foundation can be done. So after the well foundation is done, what happens? This looks like a box, so it is box well foundation. Okay, with the box caisson well foundation. And then we have the pneumatic cushion. It has a working chamber at the bottom of the cushion, which is kept dry by forcing out water under pressure. Okay, which is kept dry by forcing out water under pressure, thus permitting excavation under dry condition. Okay, pneumatic cushion. It has a working chamber at the bottom here, right? At the bottom of the cushion. So that what happens when there is underwater pressure is more, it will force out the by it because here working this chamber is here, na? So the underground here. Okay, here the water is here, so under there under pressure due to this, so there is a working mechanism here in the pneumatic cushion where this water, it will force out the underwater. This is the water under which is pressure. Okay, which is the water which is under pressure. Okay, so this was your type of well foundation based on the your cushion. You can see this is your open cushion. Simply drawing and showing. So this is your open cushion. You see this is the cushion here from the both sides. It is built here. It is open, open, and here also at the top it is open. At the bottom also it is open. Only these two are drilled inside here, you can see. Okay, it is driven inside these cushions, and here this is the hard strata here. So hard strata is directly over there. Then here now the well construction is being done. Okay, concreting and then well foundation is done. Okay, so this is your open cushion well foundation. This is the cross section, you can see. Okay, this is double D well foundation open cushion. This double, it is double D based on the shape, it is double D, but it is based on the cushion also, it is open from top and as well as from the bottom, it is open. So it is open cushion double D well foundation. Okay, so you know you, when we construct a well, this is the normal method. Like here we have the cutting edges are here. These are your cutting edges which will, when we insert these cushions, what happens, they will be cutting the ground and then fixing themselves or on the hard strata also. So these cutting edges are always your sharp here, and then this is known as your curve here. This is the bottom plug, dredge well, sand fields, and then here sands are inserted here. This is open here. Okay, then this is above the water level here, average water level. When we have a high water level, it comes here. When we have a normal water level, this is the normal well. Okay, so we have here open cushion well foundation. This is one of the example open cushion, open from both the top and the bottom. Okay, cushion is here rectangular. Okay, so this is the rectangular cushions are used. Now the box cushion, you see the box cushion here, this from the bottom it is closed, from the from the top it is open. Okay, so this is known as your box cushion. And this is your RCC walls. Okay, sand filling is done here, and the RCC, these are your RCC walls. Now, if we see the sectional elevation, we have this one. Plan is this one. This is the plan of your box cushion. That means this is the two, then this side again two rectangular is there. Okay. This is another box cushion. That means the bottom is closed and the up top is open. Like here, the four rectangular was made here. In the same way here, circulars are made. Okay. Box cushion, circular box cushion. Then we have, this is the pneumatic one. Okay, where there is a working mechanism in the bottom. Okay, so these are your cutting edges. Obviously, this is always present, cutting edges. Here one working chamber is there. Okay, this is your water worker airlock. This is your material airlock, water line. Compressed air supply is given by these. Bucket is here. Okay, so we have a case study. I don't think we'll do the case study. We'll not do the case study. Like we will not go and see different ones. I will show you some, again another PPT on your this thing, the cushion one. I will show you. ओके क्वेश्चन ना, सो दीज आर योर टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. टू सी वन थिंग, ओह सॉरी सॉरी, सो दीज नाउ विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द क्वेश्चंस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, बट स्टिल आई वांट टू शो यू अबाउट द क्वेश्चंस बिकॉज़ विद द हेल्प ऑफ क्वेश्चंस ओनली यू आर गोइंग टू डू ऑल द फाउंडेशन वर्क्स. सो क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट, दीज आर योर टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. इट कैन बी बॉक्स क्वेश्चंस, इट कैन बी ओपन क्वेश्चन, न्यूमेटिक क्वेश्चन, वी ऑलरेडी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस, ओपन एट द टॉप एंड रो. सो या, सो ओपन केसिंग अगेन कैन बी सिंगल मल्टीपल सिलेंडर्स, लाइक वी हैव सीन इन द अर्लियर अर्लियर स्लाइड्स. व्हाट वाज दैट, फोर नंबर ऑफ ओपन वेल वाज देयर, राइट? सो द ओपन क्वेश्चन कैन बी वन, मल्टीपल और सिलेंडर्स. ओके, सो वी हैव बॉक्स क्वेश्चंस, वी हैव ऑलरेडी सिंस. ओके, वेल फाउंडेशन इज नथिंग बट योर क्वेश्चंस, हाउ द क्वेश्चंस विल बी, how the question is like open, whether it is open or box, your that means your well foundation will be the same obviously. So these are, we have already talked about this open questions. First question is a strong watertight visual, open at the top, and yeah. And for this question is built on the land, then launched and floated to pyre site where it is sunk in position. Such a type of question is used where bearing stratum is available at shallow depth and where loads are not very heavy. So box question where we use when we need some shallow foundations. Okay, shallow well foundation, it is not, and the loads are also not so high. Okay, so open question or well, this is in this way. That was your box. Box when we use in the shallower depths, we have here open question. See, open, it is open here and it is closed here. Wow, well cap is there. So all open and open caisson is a box of timber, reinforced concrete, steel or masonry, which is open at the top, and another, it is used for building and bridge foundation. Open caissons are also called for well foundation. So these are your different, we have already talked. Then we have multiple well or monoliths. So these are your monoliths. One monolith is there. You see, just we had already seen this thing, like multiple openings are there, open caissons or open wells, you can see. So multiple wells, the monoliths wells which are sunk together, each individual well has got a separate cutting edge and dredging in each of the well can be done separately. As the monoliths are of bigger dimension, they cannot be built on the site in the water. Okay. Okay, the dredging well should be large enough to permit easy passage. Okay, cylinders, we know. Disadvantages, some of the disadvantages are what, you know, as the diameter of cylinder is small, its load carrying capacity, this is the disadvantage of the cylinder one. Okay, so as the diameter of cylinder is small, its load carrying capacity is less, there are more chances of lifting of the cylinders. Okay, so they require additional for sinking as their self weight is less, the thickness is less, and hence they are not suitable for high bridges. Cylindrical ones are not fit for the higher bridges. Okay, when water is flowing with high velocity of flow, it is difficult to sink the cylinders. Advantages, the construction is simple, cost is low, diameter of cylinder is small, the obstruction, the water flow is less. Okay. Okay. I think we have a few minutes, so I'll share you your attendance link. Just go and give the attendance. Let me go. बिल्डिंग कंस्ट्रक्शन, ओके। Go to the link and give your attendance. Thank you. Will do it. I have shared the link. You can give your attendance, okay? Gracias.